starting the engine. And unfortunately, we can see the airbag system did not pass all the safety procedures, so it's still on. That's why it means something is wrong. Let's fix that. Hello, I'm Vladimir. You are on the BimDoc channel. Today, I'll help you to solve the airbag issue that is very common on a lot of BMWs, especially the old ones, the E-series. Today, as example, we have that BMW X3. This is E83 platform. But don't hesitate to watch that video until the end, because it doesn't matter what exactly car do you have. E-series, E60, E65, E70, even F-series or even G-series, the principle will be exactly the same. Of course, on F and G series, the software to be used is a bit different, but if you know how the system works and how to bypass all the issues, you'll be good. As you have seen in the beginning of the video, that car has a problem with the airbag system. The airbag system is starting, it's passing all its security procedures, and it's still being on. It means something is wrong, it will not function properly. Today, as example, we'll have that BMW X3. This is E83 chassis. But don't hesitate to watch that video until the end if you have another platform, because it doesn't matter if you have, for example, 5 series E60, 7 series E65, X5 in A70 chassis, or whatever other E series. The principle of the system will be exactly the same. All the software to be used will be exactly the same. That's why that video is very beneficial for all E series owners. And in addition, if you know how the system is working, you will be able to disable the same problems in F and G series as well. To begin, in order to fix something, you have to understand how it works. On BMWs, 4 main issues what might cause the airbag light to be on. The first one is passenger occupancy detector. The second one is belt pretensioners. Third one is some kind of sensors inside the car, more specifically acceleration sensors. And the fourth reason is something is actually wrong with the airbags. From those 4 different errors, I'm not disabling the airbags, because airbag system is very important. In case of crash, if you have disabled whatever airbags, the owner of that car will not even know that there's something wrong with the car. That's why my recommendation, do not disable not airbags or any sensor that's responsible for that system, because in case of crash, you'll be responsible. And the first two, the passenger occupancy detector and belt pretensioner, those are the systems that go off really often. And that's why, because this car is kind of old, replacing those parts with a brand new one is not beneficial at all. Of course, if you'll disable the passenger occupancy detector or belt pretensioner, all the other system will remain working. So in case of crash, airbags will be deployed. That's why it is not so critical, and we can play with that. In the passenger seat, there is a special mat that is sensitive to the pressure. So if someone is sitting there, the car will know that the passenger actually is present there. So in case of crash, the airbags have to be deployed in order to save someone's life. The problem with those detection mats, that they are so sensitive that if, for example, you will place your lady in a doggy style position on the passenger seat, with her legs, she will apply so much pressure to the sensor mat, it will go off. Or even if you drop your laptop back to the same passenger seat, you might, with that action, break that passenger detection mat, and that's why you will have problems with the airbag system. That's why that detection system is very sensitive, so be very careful if your system is working well. Official way to fix that will be to disassemble the seat totally, replace that mat, and you will fix the issue by that action. So how do the pretensioner system works? If you attach your seat belt to the seat belt buckle, and in case of accident, inside the pretensioner system there is pyrotechnical cartridge built in. So in case of accident, it will be fired up, and it will tension your belt way faster before even the airbags will be deployed. And the closer the seat belt will be towards your body, the higher chance are that you'll survive that crash. And in today's video, I'll show you 2 options. First, how to disable the seat occupancy detection, and also the second, how to disable the seat belt pretensioner system. I'm very aware that that issue is very common on a lot of BMWs. That's why if you really do like my videos, please share current video with your friends, because I'm 100% sure at least one of those has BMWs and at least once in a life had the same issue. That's why, enough talking, let's go for action. For current job today, we'll need some kind of computer with a special software. So you'll require some software to code E-series. That will be the NCS Expert. The hardware we'll be working with, actually even DCAN cable will work. I work with the ICOM or VCX-SC, but DCAN will also be fine because it will be coding, not programming. That's why it's totally safe. Also, you'll require INPA or ISTA to delete the errors. This is also a necessary step. And let's go. Step one will always be making the diagnostics, because you have to know what to disable. I'll use the VCX-SC, I'll connect over the Wi-Fi and make the full diagnostics for the car. On my channel, when it was in Russian, actually I already made the video how to properly use the ISTA, that's the diagnostic software the dealers are using to properly scan the BMW. If you are really interested in such video, also absolutely please show your interest with the comments, and I'll make the video about the how to properly use ISTA to diagnose your car professionally. Because I have already diagnosed the car, I will not make it second time. I have made a screenshot. So on my screen currently, you can see we have problems with the belt tensioner on front passenger, and also the second MRS system. It is multiple resistance system, seat occupancy detector. So we have two issues, as I promised you. That's why in order to fix those, you have to make a certain manipulations with the car. BMW always recommends, before working with whatever part of the safety system related to the airbags, always disable the car battery. Just remove the negative cable of the car battery. In that case, no electricity will be in the system. After removing the car battery, wait for at least 10 minutes, so no power will be in condensators as well. And that's why you'll be safely to disconnect and connect all the parts of the resistance system. First, I'll show you where is the connector for the occupancy detector is located. We'll disconnect that, and then I'll show you where are the connectors for the seat belt pretensioners, and I'll show you how to disconnect those as well. The easiest way how to access to the connector of the occupancy detector is over here. So have a look. Under the seat, there will be a special plug. You just need to unplug that. Usually, all the systems are located under there. So lift your seat as high as possible and just disconnect current connector. So let's go under the seat. So I'll try to show you in the better details. So actually over here you can see that box. It's not convenient. I'll make a focus. Yeah, that's good. So you can see current box, and you can see that plug. The seat occupancy detector will have the plug with the three wires, that blue one. So you need just to disconnect that one. Just take it and disable it, and yes, that's it. To make sure, just see if there are three connectors. Yes, this is the right one. That will be enough. During the step of the diagnostics, we have also seen that in addition to occupancy detector, we have the problem with the passenger seat belt tensioner. So let's disable that system as well. So obviously that system is located actually over there. I'll try to show you. I'll just use my zoom. Yes, so you can see that connector. So it's connected to the seat belt bucket, and that connector, it's with the red circle at the moment. You need to pull that off. The easiest way to disable that, you have to open the cover. So, and when the cover is lifted up, just take the pliers and you can lift all that system. And as you can see, I have removed that one, so it is not connected. That will be enough. It is always an option to just cut through the wires, but in case if you have to restore that system, that will be way harder to do. The reason why the belt tensioner system is going off, actually there are two reasons. The first, that pyrotechnical cartridge, its resistance is going off, and that's why the system detects there is some kind of malfunction. But the most common problem is inside the wiring and the specific that plug. The official way to fix that is to replace the whole wiring between the pyrotechnical cartridge and the airbag brain itself. BMW officially just replaces all the wirings. We have disabled the detection mat and the belt pretensioner. Now it's time for coding. Let's connect the battery cable. Let's attach the additional power to the car because we'll be making the coding. And if something goes wrong, we'll have just more time, not running through the battery itself. But additional power supply is not mandatory for that procedure. You can make the same work on engine running. So I have started the ignition. At the moment you can see the airbag is still on. A lot of other errors are present, but it's okay because I have disabled the battery. I haven't started the car yet, so it is not our problem. And I have connected through the VCX SE to my computer and let's start coding. So I have connected to the car. If you're using DCAN, then Easy Connect is not needed. If you're using ICOM or VCX SE, the Easy Connect is needed. Connect to the right platform, choose the right profile. I always recommend you to choose the expert profile. Now choose your right platform. If your platform is not present here, for example, if you have E90 and actually you don't see E90 here, then use that cheat sheet. So actually in NCS dummy, that's perfect. And over here in chassis, have a look. For example, if you have E90, you have to connect as E89 and so on. So please use that screen as a reference. But in current case, we have E83, this is X3. Let's press connect, read out the data. If you don't know what is the FA, see my video. I'm explaining that on F and G series in the ACs, but the principle will be the same. You have to go back and you have to process the airbag ECU. Because I'm not sure the state of the airbag ECU itself, I'll read it out. And I'll recode it to the factory settings first, because I know that that car was already visiting other shops who are unable to fix that. That's why they might have made any internal changes inside the ECU. I have I'm not aware of. That's why I'll just recode it with the empty man file. It will restore all the factory settings. Just make sure the man file is empty. Man file is empty. That's good. And I'll just recode it. It will restore it to the factory settings, and now I'll be 100% sure in what state is the airbag ECU, and after that I can disable the occupancy detector and the belt tensioner. So the coding process is going on. On the newer cars, the coding process will be faster. On older cars, as that one, it will take a bit more time. And the process has ended. The airbag light is still on, but it's okay. Now let's one more time read out the same ECU, make sure the ABG is selected. On other platforms, the airbag ECU might be called differently. It could be ACSM or ABG, something like that. Why we need to read it out, you'll see in a second. So at the moment, coding is active, it's reading. You can close that window, it's not needed. From current window, you'll require the MRS4RD.C60, that information. On your car, it could be different, but it is still okay. Just remember that one. Now you can collapse the NCS expert. I highly recommend you to use an NCS dummy. Open it up, select the right platform. In my case, it's E83. Now select the right module. Remember, in the NCS Expert, we have checked that, and that will be MRS4RD-C60. Browse file, open the TRC file with the current name. Make sure it is TRC file, not the man file, the TRC file. Open it up, and in current file, we need to disable certain parameters. First, I recommend you type a keyword like that one, find, and actually here you can see the seat occupancy detection.
At the moment it is active. Deactivate that one and continue with the search. Detection level OC3, it is not active, it should be good. So basically you have to disable whatever occupancy detection is active. So this is delay seat occupancy detection. Actually, we don't need to disable that because it's delay in parameters. It's okay. Seat occupancy detection number 2. Also, let's put it to not active. And just cycle through until you see that all detection is in not active. Delay is not a parameter and we have made the whole circle. That's good. With that function, we'll disable only the occupancy detector. But also we have belt tensioner. So, as you can see, driver seatbelt tensioner, it also has that one, but actually we haven't disabled the driver one, we have disabled only the passenger one, so we don't need that parameter. Passenger seatbelt tensioner, you can see it's active. Let's put it not active. And now, cycle through until you will make sure that whatever is connected to passenger belt tensioner is disabled. So, we should be okay. I have checked all the parameters. Press export and export to the man file. The log has written us, so it is exported to the man file. Go back to your NCS expert and now hit change job, SG Cadiran, OK. And now if I press execute job, the coding will start. So with my camera, I'll show the screen what's actually happening there. Now on my laptop, I'm pressing the execute job. You can see the coding is active. On the dashboard, you'll see the system will go on, off. In some cases, after coding is successful, the system could already be disabled. In some cases, erasing the errors is also needed. Let's see how it goes in our case. The coding is still active. It's still going on. Coding is ended. At the moment you can see the airbag is still on. Let's turn off the ignition. Let's try to turn it on. And you can see the system is still malfunctioning, but it could be still okay. Let's try to remove the errors. So with the ISTA I have connected to the car, I have erased all the errors, and now have a look to the screen. You can see the MRS system, zero errors. So the airbag system is green and no errors are present. And the same situation you can see actually in the car itself. I'll turn off the ignition so the test will be actual. When I'm turning on the ignition, the airbag light should go on. It means the system is passing all its security checks. And then it should go off. If the airbag is not even going on for any second, it means the system is definitely not working and something is being reworked with that. We have other errors still present because it's old car and it needs to be driven a bit, at least 1 meter, and then all errors will be gone. Now, when we have coded everything and we're sure everything is working okay, now it's time to use the insulation tape to cover all those open plugs so no dirt, anything will go inside there. That might be needed in the future. And finally, I took the car out. I drove just 1 meter out from the garage, starting the car. And you can see no errors are present. Everything is working as it should. And that was easy, wasn't it? The main factors to consider before do any coding: disconnect all the hardware parts first and code only after that. You can use that life hack on E, F and even G series. If you do like my videos, please consider subscribing to my channel. That will definitely help my channel to grow. Hit a like and see you next time. Bye.